This is one about this old South Alabama boy, see, and he liked to ride them motorcycles. I mean, he just loved to ride motorcycles because it did something for him. I mean, well, he did. He traded his pickup truck in on one. Got a Jim Dandy with a Stratofreeze air conditioner on it. On a motorcycle, can you imagine that? Weird looking. And he had an aviator cap, you know, and he had little zippers in the side so that his sideburns would hang out because he was proud of them. Had zippers up the sleeves and zippers on his back and a tattoo on his arm saying, Mammy, you the most. He's got a girlfriend and her name is Baby. And she looks just exactly like Chuck, only its difference is she ain't got no sideburns. He's got her stashed in the sidecar. See, he won't let her sit on the buddy seat no more because he thinks it's not enough class. You know, Elvis has got two or three motorcycles and sidecars, and so he's got to keep up with the Elvises. See, that's on his mind. He's even got a stereo on his motorcycle. Man, where he can hear Elvis sing this new wild, strange song.
Don't ever, don't ever, don't ever, don't ever, sometime, won't you do it?
That's a brand new one. That ain't released yet. Well, anyhow, they're sitting there, you see, and he's got this cigarette over here in this side of his mouth, toothpick out the other side. And he's watching this waitress walk away toting this tray. Something other look like glory. Like little animals when she walks. He's hung up on her. Of course, she's married and got three kids and her husband's overseas. She's getting her allotment check and she's sneaking that money at the drive-in. So anyhow, Chuck says, Baby.
She say, Huh? He say, Let's blow this joint. She say, No, man, pass it on to the waitress.
He said, I mean, let's get out of here.
She said, All right, man, let's go.
So it started out, you know, rah,
rah. She said, Turn ignition on, you smart aleck.
Turn the ignition on, click, you know, rah, rah, rah. Bam, rah. Going out down the highway, 85, 90, 110, 115 miles an hour. He's winging in and out of that traffic. Them sideburns blowing in the breeze. She's sitting scrooched down in the buddy seat. Which is inside the sidecar. Yeah, she liked to feel like she was riding on something anyway, whether she was or not. And so she was sitting there looking around, and she reached over and hollered at him. She'd say, Hey, Charles! He can't hear, you know, and the aviator cap's down over his ears, you know, and it's muffling out the sound.
Say, Hey, Charles.
He still don't hear. She reaches over and hits him a little love tap. Whap! And his head goes forward and his teeth just all crumble out on them headlights. He raises up his ear flap and says, What's the matter, baby? She says,
Stop the machine.
They're doing 115 miles an hour. He says, Dear hearts, it don't even raise up in back. He says, What's bugging you, baby? A tooth hanging on a little string. He flips it off out into the ether.
She said, Charles, I'm cold, you know that? So I'm not sitting on a buddy seat no more hanging on to your latissimus. Said, I'm freezing.
He said, We'll fix that up.
She said, You know, Chuck, you smart.
He said, Uh-huh. So I don't know what's in every book and every library in the world.
She said, What's that, baby?
He said, Words.
She said, You is wise, Chuck, man. You too wise. Hey, look, say, what you gonna do?
He said, We'll take off your leather jacket, baby, and turn it around and zip it up the back. Zip, pop, and put the collar up over your face. You'll be warm.
She said, My, you something.
So he does that. Now she's got her jacket on backwards, sitting in the sidecar. He tries to start the motor up again. Rah, rah.
Turn ignition on.
I mean, he's dense, you know what I mean. I mean, he's got them big boots on, you know, with the half-moon-shaped taps, saunter along in front of the pool hall on Saturday night and make the sparks fly. So the little kids look at him and marvel. Turns ignition on. 85, 90, 110, 115 miles an hour. Here's a whole bunch of traffic going up this mountain. Yeah, that's Yankee pronunciation for mountain. He's weaving in and out of all this traffic, and he sees a great big semi-tractor double-clutching E-flat trailer truck. And he gets right up behind it, and there's a little sign on the back of it saying, I might be slow, but I'm ahead of you. Oh, that tore him up. I mean, he just grabbed that halibard grip and twisted it plumb off. And that motor went up the side of the mountain. Blam, teeth, hair, and eyes all over the concrete. Wheel spinning. Here come the police. Fuzz, you know. Stop, you know. Big fishing pole on the back go zoop, 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 zoop. They come up there, crouched over the steering wheel like this, you know, and open the door and get out and walk around real slow like this. So what's going on here? What's the matter here? What's happened to these lovely children?
Little old boy standing there say,
well, Mr. Officer, say, Blap! Don't hit me no more. Sir. Yes, sir, I tell you what happened.
What happened to these children?
Yes, well, say, Mr. Charles there, he was killed outright, say, but Miss Baby was all right until me and Junior turned her head around.
Broke her cotton pick and neck.